feel like I live and breathe towers now. It's just like one of them things. You just get into it, and it's like an addiction almost.
It's an awesome job. Best job I've ever had. I've had quite a few jobs myself. One of my weaknesses is boredom with a job. Just can't keep the mundane. I get weak with it, and I quit. I want to find something new. This job, I got the exhilaration of many different aspects on the tower. And, I mean, honest to say, a lot of good people.
Everybody comes here for some reason.
I used to work at the cabinet shop with somebody who worked here.
And so I applied for this job, and I instantly made a huge, huge turnaround in my life from the lifestyle that I was living to what I is now is completely night and day.
I don't remember his name, but I remember him saying that he used to work for a place called Sioux Falls Tower, and they did cell phone stuff and climb towers, and he got really good money, and he got a shotgun for Christmas. And I was like, that's cool, they gave out guns for Christmas. And I just got sick of my job, and I was like, well, you know, it's right over here, I'll just give it a shot.
Listen, but we were riding motorcycles on Corpus Christi by South Padre, because we brought our bikes down. I didn't have one, but Willie, Mike, and Hush did, and they let me borrow one of theirs, and I was just like, you know, 2 weeks ago I was spraying lawns, hating life, and now I'm riding a motorcycle on a Sunday in Corpus Christi by South Padre Island or whatever, you know, like, that was awesome.
You know, the camaraderie with the guys, too, is awesome. Just being able to, you know, trust them, because basically you're up there, you know, you trust them with your life when you're riding the line. You know, you're working on at the bottom of the tower, they're up there throwing stuff around. You know, there ain't not everybody in life you can trust like that.
One day you'll be a truck driver, a lumberjack, and an electrician in the same day. And you won't. I don't think a lot of people realize that with this job, that it's always something different. It seems like things kind of drag out sometimes, but the next week you'll be doing something entirely different in an entirely different part of the country.
The Chinese are trying to win a war, one shackle at a time.
Tony's, when he cut off his pants and he put on his snake boots.
Those pictures are still floating around out there. Yeah. I'll have you know.
It'd be from Puerto Rico to North Dakota in no time, which I've done, I think, twice. Yep. Every time I go to Puerto Rico, it's straight to North Dakota.
I mean, you can imagine, in truck stops, there's some weird people in there. Okay, then we'll go in there, and I'll let's say we'll just walk in, and I'll see the guy to the right, real tall, weird guy, creeping everybody out, of course. And I'm like, whatever. So anyway, if I go get my little supplies or whatever, by the time I look back, this guy's talking to Kenny within seconds. Hey, 6'7" or what? How tall are you? And Kenny's like, yeah, 6'5", man, close, you know. And he just running his mouth to this guy. And I'm like, did you know that guy? What's going on? He's like, dude. Weird people are attracted to me. It's been a curse my whole life.
Yeah. They're just creepy animals, you know? They just, they freak me out. I don't know. Not a lot of stuff really, truly scares me, but even a little gardener snake, I run from every snake I see. There's no exception. I don't trust them. I don't see why anyone should. I haven't yet to see a snake do anything good for any human.
Guy I don't think has ever seen a shovel. We got to go on. By the time we were done, he was a master shovel.
You should have seen that one I dug in Williston.
Yeah.
You could have drove the boom truck down that thing.
I've seen pictures of
it. Personally, I'm always looking ducks and geese, and you see a whole flock of geese come underneath you. It's kind of tempting to chuck a bolt at them.
It's just the simple pleasures in life that makes the day go grand.
What are you talking? That's the best piece of equipment we got. Is he busting your hump? Well, bust his hump back. Something like that. What are you talking? Like, you mean about? What are we talking about? Yeah. And then, let's see here. The best one I thought I ever had, but he don't even work here, so no one's going to get it. Brian Bug!
Having guys, surrounding yourself with good guys, guys that you know. You know, are capable and willing to save you if something goes wrong, too. You know, having those guys around always makes you more comfortable. I know that both BC and T, if something was to happen, would be up there, you know, busting their hump, making sure I got down all right, or getting me to at least a safe position to get me off the tower. So having those other guys out there really helps.
Satisfaction, excelling at something that most people won't even attempt. It's a neat feeling.
And me and Leland and Ammon were up there about 1,700 feet. Or no, maybe the tower is 1,700. Maybe we were about like 1,400 or 1,500 feet. And an immensely thick cloud of fog rolled in. This was Christmas Eve last year. This was Christmas Eve. An immense cloud of really thick fog rolled in. And we couldn't see the ground, couldn't see more than 100 feet in any direction. And then it started snowing, snowflakes that were like, they were big, really biggest snowflakes I've ever seen in my life. Just coming down. Every direction you looked, it was all snow and fog. 5 minutes later, it just rolled out. You see the ground again, see the sky. That was cool. That was cool.
I think the environment, like I said, the camaraderie, but just the fact that, like, in 2.5 years, I learned something new almost every day. So, I mean, that keeps it exciting for me, keeps it fresh. Like, especially even from going to civil, to tower, and now we're in the communications side of tower. I mean, like, every year it seems like I'm doing something completely different, but still keeping all the stuff I learned before with me. Like, it keeps it interesting, keeps my mind occupied. So, that's my favorite part about it, so.
I mean, mine is definitely, I love traveling. Mm-hmm. Can't complain about the money, and the work is just really interesting. I still, to this day, am proud to say what I do. You know, I'm proud to, and not only because I know people think it's interesting, and I know that they really don't know about it. You know, oh yeah, you guys do turbines. Like, right, of course we do. Like, no one really knows when you say tower work what you really mean or what it really entails of until you start maybe showing them a video, a picture, whatever it be, and then they just like, of course, you're crazy and all that stuff, you know, and I mean, I think that it takes, this job takes, but it gives twice as much back. You know, like, it takes your time, but like what Kenny's saying, like, you learn a lot just about the job, about, you know, people, but then you learn tons about yourself. You know, like, because you get pushed out there. You find out what you're kind of capable of. Puts you in some situations where you're going to either have to buck up and see what you're made of, or you're going to fold. And if you're still here, well then I like to think that I bucked up so far.
On a long, lonesome highway, west of Omaha, you can listen to the engine moaning out his one note song. You can think about your loved ones or the girl you met the night before. But your thoughts will soon be wandering the way they always do when you're driving 16 hours in a Sterling with your crew. And it don't feel much like texting, you just wish trip was through. Saying, here I am on the road again. There I am upon this day. Here I go to a wind farm again. And there I go. Then you pull into a gas station, all strung out from the road, and you feel the eyes upon you as they're checking out your load. Seems they always want to bother you about the way your wheelers stood. Most times you can't hear them talk, other times you can. All the same old questions, what the heck's a tower hand? When you tell them you climb towers, they just say that you're mad. there I am, up on the stick. Here I go, to a winter farm again. There I go, doing the pain. Up there on the slick stick, you're a million miles away. Not much to hang on to, hope the climbing pegs don't break. And the RF heats your body as you climb the final bay. Later in the evening, as you lie awake in bed, with the whispers from the big iron still swirling in your head, you smoke the day's last cigarette, thinking turbo, you're not dead.
That one?
Jeez, man.
Hollywood.